I love TWB. The first days we walked in and they gave us toys, you know, wrapped up in little boxes. It felt like Christmas. And we got like this dance mat. My teammate and I just jumped up and down on this mat that made music for like 30 minutes. And that was our class.
So when it comes to learning, motivation is key. So we create a fun environment in which students aren't afraid. They're super driven and motivated to succeed. And sometimes you have to be a little bit goofy to break down those traditional barriers.
2BB is this great intro class that is mechanical engineering in a very hands-on setting.
In lecture, we learn about all the components that make a toy fun, from how it plays, to how it looks, to how all the little knickknacks just come together to make that product unique.
And then in labs, we actually get the opportunity to apply what we've been learning in lecture, mostly from that week, to our toy. We walk into the lab and they say maybe 5 minutes worth of instructions, and then they just say, go. I drew my elephant on a piece of wood, and then immediately just started cutting it with a bandsaw and like sanding it, and then, yeah, it turned into this.
Over the years, we've had all kinds of crazy and super fun toys come out of the class.
Lightning Strike is a game where you have a target and a lightning bolt, and you have to protect your target with paddles.
RC Battle Boats is a game of boats trying to sink each other while not getting sunk.
Watermaster is a wrist-mounted toy that will shoot water based on how fast you can punch.
We started out with brainstorming sessions where we had to throw as many ideas per minute as you could. So a lot of the ideas were horrible.
From there, we tried design prototypes to illustrate what exactly we were trying to do with the toy concept that we had in mind.
Toy product design is about serious fun. It isn't just about being serious. We go to the Children's Museum. We play test. We try out the ideas in very simple ways. We learn from that, and then they go back and they actually kind of start over. That is, in fact, when a lot of magic happens in engineering design, when you can feel alive and feel the passion and are willing to do the work, great things happen.
I think it's really fun to build something that little kids are going to use because they see the world in such a different way, and you could give them some product and they could use it totally differently than what you expect. And that creates a challenge, but also a really fun process.